Pickle, let's go to the hotline. And let's bring in the head coach of the 2-0 undefeated Joaquin Rams, fresh off of a big win over Groveton. We are joined by Coach Wade Lawson. Coach, how are you?
Doing good. How about yourself?
I'm excellent. How are things in beautiful Joaquin, Texas?
Hey, sun's shining today, so everything's going good.
I want to ask you about your big win on Friday night, and it's kind of two-pronged. First and foremost, it's always good to be 2-0, and to do it in the fashion you did, 41-0 over Groveton, I know is very special to you. Did it mean a little bit extra because Groveton was the team that knocked you guys out of the playoff last year?
Oh, no doubt. You know, it was something we had talked about, you know, all week. It was one of the reasons that, you know, we chose to play Groveton this year in non-district. You know, me as a coach, I always like if I have the opportunity to play someone who beat us the year before, I want to play them. You know, I think that's how you get better. You have to develop a sense of competitiveness in yourself and your team that, you know, that if somebody gets the best of you, you got to go want to play that team again. And it was something that we talked a lot about with our kids over the week. And we felt like that, you know, last year in the playoffs, we just didn't put our best foot forward that night. And, you know, like I said, I was really proud of our kids and the way they responded to it. And we come out and we put together, you know, 48 good minutes of football this past Friday.
Well, and the biggest thing that stands out to me is that this is a Groveton team that obviously has a lot of weapons, and you guys were able to completely shut them down, you know, pitch a shutout on them. What was working for you guys defensively that allowed you guys to come out with such a dominant win?
Well, one of the things was last year, when we got through playing them last year, me and my defensive coordinator, we went back to the drawing boards, and we've played good defense here the last few years. I mean, 2 years ago, we went into district and hadn't allowed a point all season. And we kind of hang our hat on our defense. Our offense gets a lot of notoriety just being a slot T team and being different and, you know, what we do. But we really hang our hat on our defense. And last year in the playoff loss to them, you know, they kind of exposed us in some ways. So we went back and went to the drawing board of how we could make things simpler on defense, to get our calls in, to go fast, to, you know, a lot of the same thing that colleges are having to do now, to be able to, you know, send blitzes, but be able to do it out of multiple personnel groupings of the offense, and not have to check out of it and get vanilla just because they check and move to something else. So and like I said, it was a lot learned in that loss last year. And like I said, I thought our kids did a really good job Friday night of taking to the coaching that we gave them and going out and executing.
Talking with Joaquin, Coach Wade Lawson here on Texas Football Today. Get involved in the conversation, hashtag TF Today. Coach, one of the remarkable things about your 2-0 start is this team's real young. Real young. I mean, I look up and down your roster and at your depth chart, and you got a lot of sophomores. You got a lot of freshmen, especially at key positions for y'all. What have you seen from your youngsters? Because I think there's, you know, especially after such a strange offseason and things like that, there's a lot of excuses for young teams to struggle out of the gate. Why haven't you guys done that?
Well, I think a lot of it is just, you know, building a tradition over years. You know, if you go back and you look at this will be our sixth year in the program now, and we've been fortunate enough to put more wins in the win column every year. And those kids that we have, you know, now those freshmen, those sophomores, even from the time when I got there and they were in peewee football, they're running the same offense that we run now. And so it's not any different for them. Now, there's a huge jump from eighth grade football to playing high school football on Friday nights. But, you know, those kids know what the expectation is for them. They know that, you know, what we as coaches expect from them. They know what to expect from each other, and they know what our town expects from them. And, you know, and then that's to go put a good product on the field every Friday night. And, you know, we hang our hat on. We may not always be the most talented team on the field, and that we can't control, but we can control the pace, and we can control the competitiveness that we play with every Friday night. And, you know, if you look at us right now, we're starting a freshman and five sophomores. You know, that's a lot of youth on the field. You know, a lot of, you know, that freshman's still 14 years old. So he's a baby. And, but he's going to be a good one for us. And Gage Jordan, really, I mean, he's playing, you know, wheel linebacker and fullback for us. You know, those are key components in what we do on both sides of the ball. And then, you know, our sophomores, they're a really good group, and you know, we're real proud of them.
So one of the things about building a tradition and you being there for 6 years is, you know, you mentioned you guys are a slot T team. And I always love talking with coaches who coach the slot T, because the slot T is the devil. And one of the things about it is the slot T is not a star making offense. It is not a
exactly.
It is not an offense where you're going to have some bell cow guy who goes out there and puts up these record shattering numbers. And sometimes I feel like that can be hard to convince kids to want to run that offense. Do you feel like now that you guys have helped to establish this, what is a winning tradition there at Joaquin? You know, you're 36 and you're now 41 and 18 there over your 5+ years. Do you feel like it's getting easier to get kids to buy in on that kind of offense?
Yeah, if I told our kids we were doing something else, they'd look at me like I was crazy. You know, and I'll say this, you know, if you look at our roster, you take a kid, Kay Nackinson, right now, he's playing guard and Mike linebacker for us. You know, he was a fullback last year for us on our team. And, you know, I brought him in over two-a-days. He actually started the year in the backfield. Him and Maddox Hutchins both did. And I brought them both in the office and said, look, I need one of you to play guard, and I need the other one to go play strong end for us. And, you know, they looked at me and said, yes, sir, that's what we need to do. That's what we got to do to win. You know, that's one thing we have. We have great kids at Joaquin, and they're unselfish. And, you know, at the end of the day, they just want to win on Friday nights. They don't care who totes the ball, who has the yards, none of that matters to them. They just want to win. And, you know, when you have kids like that, it makes your job really easy. And, you know, I give a credit to that, to the kids that come before them that had the same mindset. They just knew that we're going to do whatever we got to do to win. And, you know, of course, when you look down the road and, you know, you say, you know, a lot of the things that we do come straight from Liberty Hill. Mm-hmm. When Coach Vance was there, I met with him and talked with him, and I visited with Coach Walker several times. And, you know, so like I said, it's nothing like we created it by no means. Now, we put our own little spin on it at Joaquin. But like I said, a lot of that, you know, you look at the success Liberty Hill has had, well, it's not hard to convince your kids of it. You know, it's something different. You know, everybody's in the spread. Everybody's doing that. You know, how can you be different? And, you know, our kids have really bought into it. And like I said, it's been really good to us over 6 years now.
It's on to the next one now. You guys have some, you guys got some traveling to do. You guys are heading an hour and a half north up to Orr City to Rebel Stadium to take on an undefeated Orr City squad. I know you're already deep in preparation for them. I don't want to ask you to give away your game plan, but when you take a look at what you're up against on Friday night, what do you see?
Well, first and foremost, I'll say this. You know, we've played Orr City. This will be our third year in a row to play them. And last year when Coach Burnham got that job, you know, he was an offensive coordinator at China Springs for years, so he was very familiar with the slot T playing Liberty Hill. And they were probably the most improved team on our schedule last year up until we played Harleton mm-hmm. at the end of the year from 1 year to the next. And when I see them on film, I see they've made an even bigger jump this year. And actually, he's drank the Kool-Aid too. They're actually running the slot T, so we're going to see mirror images of each other Friday night. They're a very big team. They got good numbers out, a lot of depth, and I look for them to give us a lot of trouble. You know, we're going to have to play really, really well Friday night to be 3-0, and I think our kids know that.
Finally, it's Wade Lawson, the head coach at Joaquin, joining us here on Texas Football Today. Get involved in the conversation, hashtag TF Today. Coach, I've got to ask you about, you mentioned your coordinators, your offensive and defensive coordinators. Your offensive coordinator is Jared Jones. Your defense coordinator is John Jones. They are brothers. They are brothers. That is remarkable enough. Do I have this right? Did you guys go to kindergarten together?
Yes, we started out at Joaquin. We're all from Joaquin, and we started out at kindergarten together, graduated together, lived together in college, best men in each other's weddings. You know, we're all there when our firstborn children were born. You know, been best of friends since we were 5 years old. So, and then on top of that, actually, my dad is on my staff too and works for me. So it's a, and we've got another guy there that we, that I coached when I was in high school, and Chad Lawrence. And, you know, so we have a really, really close staff. And I think our kids see that, you know, and, when we talk about being family, we really mean it, you know, and that's something that our kids, they see, and it's a pretty cool deal.
Okay, so of the guys who, I guess it's the Joaquin Elementary School class of 1997 or so, of those three guys, you, Jared Jones, and John Jones, who has grown up the least?
Well, that's a great question. We're all three pretty old souls, to be honest with you. You know, they get on to me, and they tell me all the time I'm the oldest 34-year-old in the world because I can't even hardly work a computer. I'm going to say Jared. I'm going to say Jared's grown up the least out of us all. You know, he's the offensive coordinator. He likes to have the most fun. Me and John, we're pretty old souls to be 33. Well, they're still 33. I turned 34 the other day. So, but to be honest, really out of us all, probably the youngest is my dad. he's probably the youngest, to be honest with you.
He's Wade Lawson. He's the head coach of the undefeated Joaquin Rams. Coach, really appreciate your time. Congratulations again on the great start, and best of luck Friday night against Orr City.
Hey, thank you, and thank you for having us on, man. We appreciate it.
Absolutely. There he goes, Wade Lawson, the head coach of Joaquin.